everyone. My name is Cassandra Tumasz, and the title of my research is The Comparative Analysis of Anatomical and Metaphorical Imagery on Psychological and Physical Stress in University Dances. For my research, I was interested in how dance can be seen as a therapeutic activity and escape from the stresses of everyday life. However, dance requires extreme concentration, physical effort, and discipline. Those who train intensely at the pre-professional and professional levels may feel additional pressures and burdens from classes and rehearsals. High levels of this stress increases vulnerability to injury, fatigue, and illness. Finding methods to prevent these complications is the key to prolonging dance careers and reducing chronic pain experienced both during and after training and performance careers. So what is imagery and how does it relate? White and Hardy define imagery as an experience that mimics real experience. We can be aware of seeing an image, feeling movements as an image, or experiencing an image of smell, taste, or sounds without experiencing the real thing. Eric Franklin, the founder of the Franklin Method, describes imagery and its relationship to movement as a complex redistribution of muscular tension edging towards the desired balance around your joints. Research has found that utilizing imagery trains the amygdala, which is part of the brain responsible for the stress response. It also changes the patterning of the nervous system, allowing dancers to move with the least amount of muscular effort. This is key for allowing dancers to most efficiently, avoid overuse injuries, and conserve energy. Imagery has been proven to reduce pain and injury in dance. So based on all of this information, shouldn't imagery reduce stress? Imagery is more complex than it seems. There are two main classifications of imagery, anatomical and metaphorical. Anatomical imagery focuses on a part of the body and states a biological fact. An example of how this is used in dance would be imagining that your shoulder blades are drawn together while balancing in first position in ballet. On the other hand, metaphorical imagery utilizes conventional and fanciful expressions with a focus outside of the body. An example would be imagining string is pulling the crown of your head to the ceiling. Dance educators commonly utilize either or both types during their classes. Dancers may have a preference for either type. Anatomical imagery is most effective with a basic knowledge of anatomy and biomechanics. The purpose of this study was to determine if individual dancers have an imagery preference and if the non-preferred imagery type caused them stress and in what way. We hypothesized that dancers would either have a similar or combination imagery preference, and utilizing their preference would decrease overall stress, whereas the non-preferred imagery type would increase stress. Six female dance majors between the ages of 18 to 22 years old volunteered for the study. The data collection consisted of four individual movement sections on four separate but consecutive dates. During the first movement session, participants were guided through a ballet bar and center work. The second movement session was in the genre of modern dance, the third, an intermediate Pilates mat series, and the fourth, an alignment-based and vinyasa flow yoga practice. The movement session leader demonstrated and taught each exercise before introducing an image verbally to the participants while at rest before starting each combination. The leader repeated the image audibly multiple times to remind and ensure that the participants had heard and understood the cue. Data was collected through self-report questionnaires and questions, as you will see in the following slides. This is the general participant information form that was filled out before the movement sessions, asking about previous anatomical imagery knowledge and assumed imagery preference. Before each movement session, participants filled out pre-stress questionnaires, rating their stress levels on a scale of 1 to 5, 1 being not stressed at all, and 5 being also wrote why they chose that number. After each movement session, participants filled out the same stress questionnaire with an additional question about how the session affected their number choice. Next, participants responded to the following reflection questions. One, how did the use of imagery inform your movement choice or mental viewpoint? Two, did a specific image resonate with you? And if so, why? Conversely, was there an image that confused you? Three, describe and compare how you feel now after the movement session versus when you came in. Did this positive or negative effect result from the use of anatomical or metaphorical imagery? Finally, participants filled out the imagery questionnaire, where they were instructed to either circle, cross out, or leave blank each image that was used during the session. Circling an image indicated that the participant found the image helpful. Crossing out an image indicated that the image caused stress to the participant. Additionally, participants were encouraged to comment on the image's effect. The data was then coded for patterns in the participant's thoughts, ideas, and feelings. Number of images that were circled as helpful or crossed out as having a negative impact were totaled and averaged for each movement session and imagery type. The number of positive and negative effects were totaled before and after each movement session for each imagery type. A positive effect was determined if the image helped the dancer to maintain proper alignment, execute the movement with full range of motion, decrease mental confusion about the movement, maintain focus of the movement task at hand, make a personalized and qualitative choice about the movement, or provide a sense of enjoyment in executing the movement. Negative effects were determined inhibited the dancer's ability to experience the above. Before the movement session, 5 participants reported that they preferred both anatomical and metaphorical imagery. 1 reported that she preferred anatomical imagery, but this was not prevalent in the data. All participants found that anatomical and metaphorical imagery was helpful. Metaphorical images were reported as memorable more than anatomical. However, metaphorical images were also reported as more confusing. So here I created a word cloud using all of the words from the participants' self-reported reflections, and I removed filler words such as the, or, and. The size of the font indicates how many times the word was repeated. For example, words such as felt, image, helps, less, focus, and relax were repeated the most. For the ballet movement session, half of the participants reported a decrease in stress. More positive effects were reported after the movement session than before. The amount of negative effects did not change after the ballet movement. Based off of a post-movement session questionnaire, both types of imagery were more helpful than stressful, although metaphorical images were slightly more helpful than anatomical. Anatomical imagery had more of an effect physically, whereas metaphorical imagery affected the movement as well as the mental aspects. Common positive effects from the anatomical imagery included an increased depth in movement, better alignment, release of excess tension, and feeling balanced and lifted. Common negative effects included an increase in stress, specifically when a participant had a previous struggle with a cue that was used, such as keeping the hips square or engaging the psoas, which is a major hip flexor in the human body. Common positive effects from a metaphorical imagery included a continuation of momentum, movement feeling easier or effortless, and feeling more relaxed, aligned, balanced, and stable. Common negative effects included feeling confused. This graph represents the images that were either circled or crossed out on the questionnaire. The anatomical images are represented in red, and the metaphorical in blue. As you can see on the left, Metaphorical images were circled slightly more than anatomical. On the right, you can see exactly the same amount of images were crossed out. Here are some quotes from the reflection questions that stuck out to me. One participant wrote, "The artistry comes from the metaphorical imagery. We need the anatomical to have technique that allows us to push the boundaries of movement. I believe this sums up the goal of imagery in dance fairly well." Another participant reported, "The image of wrapping a sling around the thigh decreased my stress level because if my leg fell, I blamed it on the sling." Demonstrating how this particular dancer's thought process allowed imagery to affect her sense of agency and decrease stress. Now, I will have my dancers take the stage and perform a choreographic representation of the ballet movement session.
Common negative effects included
feeling confused, and difficulty in visualizing the image. From this graph, it is clear that metaphorical images were circled as helpful more than anatomical, and anatomical images were crossed out as stressful slightly more than metaphorical. One participant reported that the anatomical imagery made my movements harsher, whereas metaphorical imagery made my movements softer and flowy. Another dancer reported that mentally, the use of imagery made me more aware of the choices I was making. I usually don't think too deeply about my movement. Some dancers enjoyed when an image was used that they heard before. I envisioned this anyways, so a little positive reinforcement was nice. And now my dancers will take the stage and perform a choreographic representation of the modern movement section. One dancer reported how the effects did not just stem from the imagery, but from the movement as well. She wrote, "I feel stronger. I think it was not only the imagery, but the movement as well." Another participant demonstrated her frustration with an image, writing, "I wanted to wring my towel out more, but my spine wouldn't let me," when referring to a spinal twist. And now my dancers will come take the stage and perform the choreographic representation of the Pilates movement session.
I am not the best at yoga,
So these images really took me out of a negative mindset, how horrible I looked doing it. And now my dancers will take the stage for the final time to perform the choreographic representation of the yoga movement session. Anatomical and metaphorical images were crossed out as stressful, relatively the same amount for ballet, modern, and yoga. Anatomical images were crossed out much more than metaphorical for the Pilates movement session. You can also see that across the board, imagery was always more helpful than stressful. The major takeaway from the study is that most dancers find both types of imagery to help aid in performance and stress reduction. So how can we apply all of these results about imagery to imagery use in technique and conditioning classes? I would highly suggest that anatomical imagery only be used with students who have previous anatomical knowledge as to not confuse or add stress. Additionally, imagery can be utilized to achieve a desired quality of movement as well as proper physical alignment, mental relaxation, and greater concentration. Specifically in Pilates, metaphorical imagery is useful in reducing stress that the nature of Pilates may cause. There are some limitations to this study. Foremost, this study had 6 participants, which is much too small for the data to be considered significant. The environment was controlled to the best of our ability, but some factors should still be considered. Movement sessions were held at the same time each day, but we could not control the participants' workload both in and outside of school, which may have caused a variance in the stress levels from day to day. The heat in the dance studio the study was conducted in was broken on the first day of data collection during the ballet movement session, causing the temperatures to be below average, which may have affected the participants' performance and attitude, as this was done in the month of January. Additionally, participants may have gained a better understanding of imagery after the ballet movement session and thus reported differently on the following grade. Lastly, it was difficult to determine if the effects from the imagery were a direct result from the imagery itself or the nature of the movement. In conclusion, imagery has many benefits in dance and cross-training. It relaxes the mind and body, improves focus and alignment, and clarifies movement quality and intention. As long as images are clear and not focused on an area of the body or scenario that... Here are some resources. And before I take questions, questions, I would like to take a moment to thank Professor Lauren Kearns, Professor Renee Ommiller, Dr. Mazima, Lynn Bisco, Professor Ann K. Hill, the Lumen Committee, the Undergraduate Research Office, my roommates, Sarah and Michaela, who are my test subjects, of course, into the study, and to my six wonderful dancers, Victoria, Brennan, May, Sarah, Kayleanne, and Ariana.